Hi friends, this is Sai and welcome back to the garden. And this is going to be the episode 4, the long tour episode, where I'm going to take you around the whole place and show you what's growing where. In the last three episodes, I've got a couple of doubts, so hopefully I'll be able to answer them in this video, especially regarding containers, regarding the diversity, and regarding what's growing, because and how do I manage the whole thing, why I decided this to be in this particular way. So I'll be answering all those questions in this video. So let's go forward and start looking at the garden. So even before I had set up the wooden containers, these Syntex tanks, this one and the one there, they were the ones which I had started putting plants in it quite some time before. So if my memory serves me right, this ridge gourd was put somewhere 4 to 5 months back, and also you can see that a bit of it is drying, or rather most of it is drying off. It is still giving very good produce. So this is one area where I can see lots of ridge gourd, and that is another area where I can see ridge gourds, birkai as we call it in Telugu. The other thing is, there is a lot of growth on top, and that is one of the reasons that when I take you inside, you'll see that at this eye level, a lot of things will be of this form. So because the whole of the top has got covered, so I'm getting a natural green green shade, or green shade net on top of my rooftop garden, and that has led to certain issues which I'll be talking more there. Now along with this, there are a few things which have been planted inside this, like chili and a few other things. Now, due to lack of sunlight, some of them have not really come up, but this is one wonderful thing which is just going along. It is getting a bit of water, and it is doing really well. This is a sweet potato. This I got it from Peter and Rosie Harding from Goa, and really happy that now I have it grown to a certain extent where I can start transplanting it into some of the farms that I am working with, or probably give a few more to my friends like Cycleyard, who's actually holding the camera, so we can start propagating it more. Now one thing which I would want to discuss here is why am I not harvesting these sweet potatoes. So whenever you are growing something as a shoot, something which is coming up, and something along with something which is going down, which is a root crop, for example, sweet potato in this case, it is advisable not to remove the root crop before this whole thing has really done its duty and it is dying off. Because if I would now pull out the sweet potato, there is a very good chance that I start affecting the roots of this creeper, or it could be the roots of any other thing that I would have planted here, like tomato or chili or okra or brinjal for that matter. So I don't want this plant to suffer, and I also know that sweet potato does really well. Last time around, which is about 2 to 3 years back when I put it, the whole vine had died off, but when I was taking out the potting mix, I could still see beautiful sweet potatoes which we could eat also. So really not worried about this crop, but if you are mixing things like this, be extremely careful of not harvesting things prematurely, because that can actually start affecting this. So you are putting things like radish, you are putting things like carrot or beetroots, be careful what you are interplanting it with. So be careful in the companion planting that you are doing. So when I was about to take this video, my friend Cycleyard mentioned that probably you should call this video as the hidden produce garden, because you can see these bitter gourds out here, kakra as we call it, and there are so many of them, and they are so hidden that they become visible only when the color is changed. And it is because I saw that I could see the other bitter gourds, and that, by the way, is something beautiful which nature does. When the seeds are ready, the color changes. And when the color changes, that means the seed is ready, and now the plant really wants to get noticed. When it is green, and some of us prefer eating it green, not that it should not be eaten when it is yellow, some of us who prefer eating it green do have a tough time trying to find that. And when it is green, the seeds are not completely ready. So nature has its own pattern of changing the colors, and this kind of an orange really makes it attractive for animals to actually start spreading its own, start spreading the seeds of this. And rightly so, one which has got opened on its own, I can see a few seeds of it already on this container. So this is the west side of my garden, and this is the shade net that I was talking of. Now this area has also done extremely well. You can see a bottle gourd resting there. This is the same position where 2 years back I had a pumpkin resting there. So this seems to be like a nice support for my gourds. Now here it might be difficult for you, but another huge, and this is like the gada of Bheem, the mace. This is another huge bottle gourd which has rested here. Around 15 days back, I wanted to remove this shade net, but I could not really succeed because a couple of vines had gone on top of it, and I really didn't want the whole thing to be disturbed. So you can still see a bit of shade net here, and the bottle gourd found a beautiful place to rest. Similarly, these are the yellow round cucumber. Got a couple of these still harvesting, so that again is a nice thing happening. Now on the ground level, on the container level, if you start seeing, these are the seeds that I was talking of, the seeds which have fallen down. These are a few things like amaranth, and here and there I can see more amaranth and probably a few spinach as well. What has happened is that this area is getting it becomes almost dark. Now the temperatures in Hyderabad have been pretty cool for the last 2 to 3 weeks, or probably a bit more than that. I can't say for sure because I've not been here for most of the time, but there's been no direct sunlight throughout the day. But whenever there is direct sunlight, and yesterday and day before yesterday, I saw that this area has a good amount of shadow, good amount of shade. And whereas where there is no this kind of a covering, there is quite a bit of sunlight. So because of that, what has happened is that most of the things that I am putting at this level, they are not getting enough amount of sunlight for them to actually grow. So that is another thing that you need to keep in mind, that when you are densely covering your roof or the top of your garden, there is always a possibility that things underneath are not going to do that well. So I'm not really unhappy or disappointed. I'm actually very happy because the gourds have been doing really well, and just by looking around like this, I can at least see about 20 of them, 20 of just the bottle gourds out there, and that is not even taken into the consideration the bitter gourds and the rich gourd. So I am having a bit of voice problem, so I might not be loud. Anyways, there is a good amount of breeze which is coming from this side. This area, now if you look at it is not that dense at this level. Whereas if you look at some of my previous videos, this whole area was pretty dense, and I could not even see anybody who was standing on the other side. And this was the place where I was talking of, it seems like this. This was the particular vine where I was talking of the aphid infestation and the ladybirds coming and all that. So now what you see is that, of course there are no leaves here, but equally well there are no aphids, and so there are no ladybirds. So this is the kind of a pest predator cycle which I really like. I get the pest, so I get the predator. If there is no pest, there is no predator, and you need not really worry about it then. So this place was really dense, and now the density has decreased. Can see a couple of bottle gourds here and there, and definitely a couple of them on the top. This is the yellow round cucumber. We were late for its harvest, so it changed its color. So let's go further. I did put few things here, like coriander and a few more things. They have not really come up. They have come to a particular size, but not really come up. Again, the reason is the lack of direct sunlight. So, if you are getting just ambient light, that is not sufficient for plants. They require direct sunlight. At least 2 to 3 years is what I think is good enough for them. Could have a bit more, perhaps just a bit less. But if you are not getting any direct sunlight, don't expect your plants to really come. So, having bottle gourds, ridge gourds, and this. As I said, wherever you see a ridge gourd, there has to be a Syntex tank there, because this is the last place, this was the place where I put it. So this is the Syntex tank where I put a couple of things, noticeably the ridge gourds. So you can see lots of ridge gourds are all in this place. You can see at least 10 in this vicinity, all at different stages of growth. So that's again a good thing. I can harvest a few, allow a few of them to grow. Now, there needs to be a bit of maintenance work, because the winds here have been, again, have been pretty strong, and a couple of days back there was such a big downpour that I was really, really afraid that what is going to happen to my rooftop garden. And you can see that some of these sticks that I have, they have actually crossed, and so there is a bit of maintenance work which is required, which will be done once I am sure that this vine has done its duty, this gourd has given all that it can give. And at that point of time, I would be resetting this, so probably in about 2 weeks or so, that would be a good time when I think I could do something with this. You can see a lot of brown matter here, and that is because of this dense covering which is there. So you've got good green, fresh, healthy leaves on top. I'll be showing you the view from the top also. So, this is one patch, and that is the other patch, and there is another new patch that I put on. Now, these patches are not really hindered by the lack of sunlight, and here you can see all the diversity that I put in. So, you can see this lovely aubergine growing well. You can see these small yellow flowers, they belong to the yellow round cucumber, so they are also doing well. I have got roselle out here, I have got red amaranth out here, and something which was not visible even to me in the previous videos is this wonderful beans coming out here. So I have got good kind of a diversity here. I have also got a couple of things like spinach that I can see. Can I see anything more? Maybe a bit of coriander growing underneath it. And when people ask me that, can we grow all these things together, I think that's the only way to grow lots of stuff, because I don't see much of a pest issue out here. Here comes the sunlight, and just if you come here, okay, and I hope the auto lighting doesn't do much, you can see how dark it is here. So this is what I was trying to tell you, that it gets, the shade is pretty good out there. Now, this brinjal, it has started to give flowers. This is also starting to give flowers. So I have put quite a bit of things inside here, and slowly they are coming up, and slowly I can also see that they are doing well. Coming on to the other side, what do we have here? We have the red amaranth, which has been doing stably, have been harvesting it. So if you see this, I've been cutting it here and there and using it. When there are too much of seed, sometimes I just take it out also, but I want to collect it for seed, so letting it remain. Have this giant roselle, and this roselle is going to flower, so going to get seeds pretty soon. Again, have got brinjals here, and very good spinach, very healthy looking spinach out here, if you can see this. Have got a bitter gourd vine also, which is climbing here. And this was the place which looks extremely beautiful. You can look at bottle god here. You can see a few ridge god there, bottle gods here. You can see it is now visible, but earlier it was pretty difficult to find it. You can see those bitter gods there, a bottle god which is about to form, fresh flowers coming up, again bottle god there, and you can see yellow round cucumber there. So, and let's just count this, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and a few more inside, and all these are practically hidden. So have to really go on a treasure hunt kind of a spree, where going and seeing where each one of them is there. And this is going to be a nice little exercise, probably going to invite a couple of my friends and get this whole thing harvested, because they are ready and can be harvested. Don't want too many ripe fruits on the vine. It is not really preferable, because once you start leaving your plants for seeding, and they are allowed to go for seeding, the plant is going to be less vigorous, because it is getting the secure feeling that it is going to have progeny. So you really don't want to do seed saving during the initial stages of the fruit coming in. You want to do it towards the end of the season. So whenever I see the ripe fruits and other things, they will be harvested immediately, because I don't want this whole thing to stop producing immediately. It can go for a couple of more months, and I would be very much willing to have that. Now, this is another small patch, which again, because I was getting too much shade here, I had to extend this. And as usual, before I can get certain things out here, nature starts putting things here. So these giant amaranths, they are not the ones which I put. I was trying more for purslane. So you can see a few purslane out here, right? And I similarly have put things like beetroots and carrots here, something similar here. This place has been left for putting a few things. A few plants which were given to me by Sai Kalyan have been put here. Which one are these? This seems to be
Kodad brinjal.
Brinjal, right? So this is Kodad brinjal. He also gave me some nice cherry tomatoes, some of them which have been put on my garden downstairs. Haven't really spoken to you about that. That is still under development, but expect to see videos from there also pretty soon. So that goes for potatoes and a few other things. I'm getting onions out here, and again, this place was put for purslane, but and a few more things. But I can see amaranth really starting to dominate. So this calls probably for a feast, so that I can finish off all this amaranth and start putting new things. Because this is a good time, mind you. This is a really good time for planting. This is the kind of temperature that you want. This is about, I think around 11 in the morning. And this is the kind of weather that you want when you, so that the plants are able to really come up. You can see how dense the whole thing becomes. You just go out on the roads and you can see there that how good the weed growth is, how well the grasses are coming. So this is a very good time for us also as rooftop gardeners or as gardeners on ground, to understand the natural pattern and really start amping up what we can do. So from here till about December, January, we are going to have a pretty pleasant climate. So if you have not started gardening, this is the time to start. Okay, so this is how the garden looks from the top view. So this is a drone kind of a view that I'm trying to show you, and this is what I meant by dense. It is almost a carpet of leaves and flowers. Looks really, really beautiful. I am shooting this from the east side, so let me just get down so that I can talk more about what's happening to the garden here. I can see again lots and lots of bitter gourds here. the previous clip was from the other side. So here you can see that this is dense, the leaves are fresh, and the spinach here is doing really well. This is what I was talking to you about in the first video. So the general health of the plants, there seems to be a bit of discoloration. So the garden does have some small slight issues, but nothing which is preventing it from giving the kind of yields which were expected of it, or which it was able to give. So not really bothered too much about it. Even initially I did have a bit of issue, but I didn't really bother about them, because the nature is going to set it. Maybe a few of them don't really live, or maybe they are not able to give good produce. But overall, the general feel for the garden is something which you start understanding, and there are certain issues that you can safely overlook and still be pretty confident about the garden in general. Now, now that we have had a good look of the garden, and we have discussed what all is growing and the general health of the plants and how well it is, the whole thing is working out, how beautifully nature is able to really bring about this abundance, let us talk more about some specifics regarding drip and regarding containers and why I did that. So let's go to a more comfortable place. So a lot of you are asking me why this container, and why did I made a shift to these containers. Well, this is your wooden containers. You get this kind of a scrap wood from Timber Depot, and you can construct it to the size that you want. The size here is roughly 2x2x2, so it is 2 feet in length, 2 feet in breadth, and 2 feet height. The intention of creating something like this, of using something like this, was that the last time around I was using plastic bags, which you would have seen, and they were good. However, it is somewhat preferable to have a bigger container. Now, what happens to the bigger container is that the roots have more area to go, and when they have more area to go, they can actually come out pretty strong. So you see all these vines which have been able to climb up. If they had been put in a small container, they would have given a yield. Maybe they would have given maybe one or two bottle gourds, or maybe a couple of bitter gourds. But what would have happened is that maybe they would have not even reached that height, because as it goes up, it also needs to build down, and when it wants to build down, it needs to have that area. So one of the important things when we are doing container gardening is to have a bigger container, so that not only can I have diversity, and I can have companion planting, and I can have multiple plants, but also that there is a lot of root space for them to expand. Now, a bigger this thing, that's why in my last video also, when I was using the plastic covers, plastic grow bags, there also I was very particular in trying to have those big bags. You also get bags which are of smaller size, and I have done in that also. It suits certain type of people for what they are trying to do. Certain types of gardeners will prefer that, but I preferred the bigger ones, 1.5 feet of height, and about 1.5 to 2 feet of the radius of that bag, the diameter of that bag. I preferred that. So that was one of the prime reasons was that I wanted to have more area. Now, some of you might ask that what is the need of bigger root space if you are not putting things which can use that. So for example, if you are putting just spinach, it is not going to use this whole area, and you might end up having to put much more of coco peat and much more of vermicompost or compost, much more of your potting mix, just for the top a few inches which a spinach is needing. So that is the reason that it's not just spinach that I'm growing. I'm growing things like amaranth, I'm growing things like these vines which are going down. So a bigger container also mandates in a particular sense trying to have the diversity. If you are just thinking of normal regular greens, you don't even have to think about that. The other thing is other thing that you need to understand is there is a certain weight which is attached to this container. So Each of these containers is at least 5 to 10 kgs, somewhere around that is how it is. Not 5 kgs, more than that, must be around 10 kgs. So if you are putting these kind of containers on top of your rooftop, be very clear that that your roof can actually support this kind of a weight. Now, because this is a house which we got built, so I know how much weight it can take. So that is the reason that I have gone for this. So no need to do this if you don't feel, or if you're not comfortable with your rooftop and you feel that it can't handle this weight. So be clear on that as well when you are thinking of this. The other particular advantage that wood has is typically your plastic can get hot. So there's a bit of sunlight coming, so the sun falls on this. There is a reflected sunlight also which falls onto the ground and gets reflected onto the container, and the container starts getting hot. When the container starts getting hot, the container is housing the potting material and the roots of your plants. The roots start getting hot. Now, roots don't want hot temperature. Roots are there inside the ground and they are used to a relatively stable temperature. Now, when they start getting hot, you will see the plant will start getting some or the other kind of an issue. It might start to wilt, or it becomes weak and there is a lot of pest attack, and all those, the whole cycle starts taking place there. So there are good strategies for that. You would have seen that a very good photo of Cyclian actually having his containers, his plastic containers, covered with cardboard boxes. So that is one thing that you can do. The other thing is having a container which is maybe made up of wood or maybe made up of mud, because both the materials are bad conductors of heat. So this is another reason why these kind of containers can be preferred. The other thing is, does this rot? So there are different types of woods which are available in the market, and you can go for a wood which is a bit more expensive, something like acacia wood. I think that is more expensive. What happens is that you can actually, for particular types of woods, you can actually have it painted, and therefore the life is definitely going to increase, because whenever you are watering or whenever it is raining, the wood is not really getting affected by the vagaries of the temperatures outside and the weather outside. However, for certain types of woods, what happens is that they are not really meant to be painted on. And this is that type of a wood where if you just look at the grain, the more paint I put, the more it will keep on, it will keep on soaking as much of varnish or paint that you put in. So, but even in that case, because these kind of containers were tried on my very good friend Dwarkanath's terrace, DJ's terrace. So we know that this is still going to last about 4 to 5 years, and even after that, maybe there are some small issues, and we can, each individual container we can look into that. The other thing is that inside I have given it a plastic lining, because I don't want too much of my wood to come into contact with the potting mix, because this is a good potting mix and it is going to slowly start even consuming this. So when we were putting gunny bags inside, we saw that the gunny bags would simply disappear after a season or so, because the microorganisms were busy at work and they would convert all that they would convert that in a way where nothing was remaining. So want these to prevent that. The other reason why we want this kind of a plastic is don't want this wood to get wet unnecessarily. So that is another reason why we want that. There are a couple of holes here, so don't want to water too much, because the water keeps on coming out. That is one of the major gripes that I had last time, was that my plastic containers had holes at unnecessary places. And with a material like CocoPeat, it is very, very important. Let me see if I can just take out a bit without hurting the plants. You see how good this is. Now, it is a bit wet right now, and CocoPeat has a tendency, just like jeans, that you just give it a bit of water. I drop a bit of water on my jeans and it's just going to roll off. But if you do something like deep watering, then it really holds a lot of water, similar to your jeans pant becoming extremely heavy once you have actually soaked it in a tub full of water. So when we want to do deep watering and you've got holes at all the unnecessary places, the water keeps on coming out, and see, when this is wet, this has a good structure, but when it is dry, it can just simply fall off and it can fly away as well. So what happens is that during that point of time we are watering and the coco peat is coming out, the vermicompost is coming out, and it is clogging up the drains, and it's just a waste of the good resource that we want. So that is another reason why this kind of plastic was put, so that there is water which is being put into this is retained and it's available for the plants to take. It is not getting lost unnecessarily, and the plants are really able to enjoy, right? So this is about the containers. Now can you use different types of containers? Definitely, as much as you can, definitely use that. But one important question which I thought people would ask and which never came up was, I have raised these containers, right? And if you would have seen the previous videos, you would have seen that I have put cement bricks down there. So if you can just see here, you can see here that these have been raised, right? And it is on top of this. Now let me just stand up, and I want to harvest something. It is so easy for me to harvest it. It is so easy for me to water anything. And that is the advantage of actually raising your containers up. You want them to be at a height where you don't have to bend this much to water. Now I can just even while I'm standing straight, I can water the whole thing. And not just that, it is only after I was able to, only after I did this, that my parents also felt very comfortable in coming and watering. So whenever I say that I have not been here for quite some time, there is somebody who's taking a bit care of, taking somewhat of care for these things, and that is my parents and my friends who are coming here. And everybody finds it very convenient to work in this garden because they don't have to really stretch their backs to get the work done. So the convenience by which the whole garden is designed is very important. It is more important than some of the other things that we seem to think are the important things. So for me, this is a pretty much of a permanent setup with good produce, with good amount of potting mix put in it. Whenever there is a lack of nutrition, I can put in my compost tea and vermi wash, and all those things are there. And this is a one-time work of putting all these things in a particular place, and that seems to be working. So maybe sometime down I might want to change a few things here and there, and that shouldn't be much of a work. But by having this at a height, it is really a pleasure to come to the garden, not just to enjoy the look, but also to work in the garden. So this is one thing which I really wanted to mention. I thought somebody would ask, nobody asked that, but I see lots of people complaining, or maybe complaining inside themselves, that gardening is a bit of a chore and chore, and really need to put in a lot of effort. No, make gardening comfortable, and that makes it pretty easy. The other thing is drip. So I do have drip. If you can see it here, I do have drip. Initially I had removed the drip, and I think I did speak about that I was not really happy with how the drip was working. But in a situation like this, I have found now that because I have had two or three pipes going through each container and having four nozzles, so for each 2 feet box that I have, 2 feet cross 2 feet, I have four holes, four nozzles which are giving the drip. So I have that as a backup. Never had a real good chance to use it till now, because whenever there is a need for watering, see that nature is watering automatically. There's been good amount of rain, and even without rain, I mean, even without regular rain, so to say, the potting mix has been so good. Just look at this. This is still wet, and this is an area which is actually open to sun. So there was a bit of rainfall yesterday. Not much as compared to what we have been getting in Hyderabad for the past month, but that has been sufficient enough for these plants. So the health of the plants is good, the leaves look fresh, so all the good indicators are there, and therefore don't need to really worry about it. So with that, let me just end this video with one last shot, okay? I'm just going to get on top of it and show you how it looks from the top. Okay, so this is how the rooftop looks. I was standing there when in the previous clip. So this is a bird's eye view of the whole thing. You can see how well it looks, completely full of leaves. Some of the flowers are going to be visible only in the evening time. Let me end this video. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe.